everyone. How are we doing today? Well, it's a bit of a different day today. Sun's gone, it's cloudy, it's quite breezy. But we've still got the fantastic view. Although it's quite misty in the distance, so can't see too far today. Last night I stayed at the Canavis Holiday Park. Very welcoming they were. Got a nice little bar on site and somewhere selling food, so I didn't have to go far for my refreshments and sustenance. Just had a little walk down this morning into Porthcothan, coffee and a sausage roll. Keep me going for a little while. It is quite chilly today, but it is a welcome relief from all the heat and sun that we had yesterday. As you can see, it's still beautiful around here. Let's give you a look around. Here we've got seabirds nesting on some of these rocks. They look like seagulls. One or two other birds knocking about. It's looking beautiful. And over there, that's where see too far at the moment, it's quite misty. See how we get on. Hopefully the sun will come out in a bit. See you later. Even when it's misty, this coastline's still stunning. Can't think of a time when it wouldn't be stunning. There it is, that word again, stunning. We're going to hear a lot of that this week, I think. Just look at this. I'll not say any more. Speaks for itself, I think. There you are in the middle of nowhere, and then you come across this. Looks like somebody's gaff. Wouldn't mind living there. I think you get some right views from that living room. Well, we just arrived at the small village of Treanen. This is Treanen Bay. Again, one of these beautiful little places. Don't seem to be a lot to do here, but who needs it when you've got this coastline? Looks like the mist's clearing up a bit. We're heading off up that way, and then over there. One thing I haven't mentioned is the colour of the water down here. I don't know if you've seen it or noticed it. You certainly don't get this colour of water up north. Beautiful. Yeah, we're just coming around to this lovely beach here. It's actually called Boobies Bay Beach. Stop giggling, you children. We're going round over there to Trevose Head. Seems to be brightening up quite a bit now. Hope to get some drone footage later on. A couple of lads down there having the time of their life. And a couple of other dogs that are enjoying down here. Yeah, there looks to be some good breakers out there for these surfers. See, I've only been down here a couple of days. I'm already a surfer dude. The RNLI there, as they are on most beaches around here. Do a fantastic job. Yeah, this is a Trevose golf course, or golf links. Had the privilege of playing here 2 or 3 years ago. Beautiful course it is. There's actually quite a lot of good golf courses down in this area, if that's the sort of thing, which it is for me. It's beautiful, I wish I was out there swinging now. Well, here we are, just heading up to Trevose Head, which is up there. Might see if I can get some drone footage up there. Those islands that you can see out there, they're called the Q-E-S, Q-E-S, Q-U-I-E-S. Well, this is the path on the way up to Trevose Head. Obviously there's the sea out there, but don't step back. All of a sudden there's this behind you. I can actually hear the waves down there, so it's obviously they're coming in somewhere. Yeah, a bit of a drop that.
Shack, he called home. Life on the road ain't so free sometimes. When a fine looking girl with a mind of her own said, walk with me, so he followed her home. She said, your shabby coat don't bother me. It don't bother me. It don't bother me. Any faithful hand, she called his name and he'd be around. She'd lead him on and quietly say, hey. She'd say, hey, dog, let's raise the roof. She turned that stray into a howling wolf. He told her he loved her. She said, I love you too. She said, I love you too. She said, I love you too. down at the range. She said, I'm sorry, dog, but my feelings have changed. I just don't think that you're the one for me. In his disbelief, he cried to tell me the truth. She said, you ain't well healed and you're too long in the tooth. Then she turned her head and she walked away. Yeah, she walked away. Yeah, she walked away.
Just dropping down from Traverse Head now, coming down into Mother Ivy's Bay. Looks a nice little beach. Then we're heading along those cliff tops, and then I think it's Padstow you can see in the distance, my destination today. And then the following day we'll be following that round all the way over there. Still quite a bit of mist up there, but it is warm. Well, that's what I thought was Padstow in the distance. Turns out it's Trevone. Padstow is still up and over that headland down the other side. Could cut across from Trevone straight across to Padstow, but I'm trying to follow the southwest coast path. And here we have Harlyn Bay. Big expanse of sand there. I have just realised that I'm presuming the southwest coast path actually goes all the way around that bay.
might see if you can actually cut down onto the beach and just go straight across the beach. We'll have to see when we get there. Well, I did manage to get down onto the beach. I don't think I really saved much time at all. But it is that time of day when it's the obligatory pit stop. Ooh, another bad boy. Well, this is Trevona Bay. Again, lovely looking little beach. We've come all the way around there. Some of my surfer dude buddies out there. And then going all the way around. That's the way we've come. You can see Harlyn Bay in the distance. And then round and round. And that's Trevoss Head. Now, I've watched quite a few YouTube videos on people doing this stretch of the coast. One thing that strikes me is everybody seems to be doing it north to south. Even today at the campsite stopped at last night, this morning one of the workers there, he said you're the first person this year that he knows of that's doing it south to north. Am I missing something? Is it less hilly going from north to south? Who knows? How dramatic is this stretch of coastline? Wow. Don't appear to be many little sandy beaches around here. But it does look beautiful. I think that's where we're heading up to the top of that hill. Down the other side and we should be in Padstow. There are a lot of birds flying around here, mainly seagulls, but I think some of them might be terns. Again, not an area of my expertise. They're all coming around. Obviously get some good thermals around here for them. Boy, he's not a seagull. Also seen quite a lot of either kestrels or falcons around this area. Been trying to get photos of them or videos. As usual, they decide to disappear when you want to take the photo. Very nice. Yeah, I think they might be moving that style in a few years' time. It's quite close to the edge. Again. Boring as it sounds, some more stunning views. Well, got a bit of a climb going up. That's up to Gumver Head. And these rock formations are called the Merope Islands. I think this one in the foreground is Lower Merope Island. And that one with a bit sticking up at the top is either the Middle Island or the higher island. Can't really tell from here. Yeah, a bit of a drag up here, up to almost at the top of Gumver Head. Definitely the toughest climb today, but again, not too bad. If you used to going up Peak District and that area. But at least the mystery of the Merope Islands. Now that there is the Lower Merope Island. This one here, that's the Middle Merope Island. And that one there, that's the Upper Merope Island. No idea why they call that or anything, but still dramatic. Ah, some brown cows. I don't know what make or model these are. Again, not an area of my expertise. I'm going to have to start looking things like this up so I can give you a bit more information. Oh, looks like things might be kicking off. What the? Don't you get any ideas, sunshine. They look friendly enough. You know when you get that feeling that somebody's watching you? Ah, a brown cow with horns. Does that mean he's a bull? He looks friendly enough. Hey up, Chuck. Look at that. Just wants a bit of cuddling. I'm getting out of here, quick. I'm just on a hill just outside Padstow. I've come across this. Must be about 30 or 40 foot high. There's nothing on it to indicate what it's being built for. I presume it's some sort of lookout post. There's some rafters up there, but no windows. You'd think if it was a lookout post, they'd have windows up top. Just these two windows here. Well, I've just asked a very nice chap, and he seems to think this has something to do with mine working. Looking on the maps, if you look, well, somewhere over the edge of the cliffs there, there are actually disused mine workings. So, it may well have something to do with that. Well, I thought Padstow was just around the corner. How wrong you can be. So we've got all that to go. I think it's just over that hill over there. So not too far. Then tomorrow across the water. And that's my journey tomorrow. Oh, here we are, we've finally made it down into Padstow. Got just under a mile to the campsite I'm going to. Done about, the way I've done it, about 11 miles today, I think. It's still been warm and stuffy, but luckily that sun's been kept at bay. That was a real killer yesterday. I hope you've liked the video again. Please give it a thumbs up if you have. And again, if you've got any questions or comments, put them down below and I'll try to answer them. This is the second day of the full week. I've done Porthcothan to Padstow today. And tomorrow it's Padstow to Port Isaac. So if you want to see more of this content, this type of thing, please feel free to subscribe to my channel. And thanks very much for watching.